Are you tired of taking pictures that look like this? Would you rather your images look more like this? Then stick around because I'm going to show you how to use Sequence Generator Pro to calibrate your flat frames. And we're getting started right as soon as I get some hot chocolate. Oh, that's so good. Flat frames are an important part of the astrophotographer's toolkit, and taking good flat frames is important. Without them, you're going to have vignetting and uneven field illumination due to any aberrations that are in your optical train. Sequence Generator Pro has a way to calibrate your flat frames automatically for you, so you know how bright your flat panel should be and for how long each exposure needs to be when doing your flat frames. For me to show you how to do these flats, it's best if we just go to the desktop and take a look at what I'm doing. In order to do a flats calibration with Sequence Generator Pro, the first thing that you're gonna wanna check is your actual profile. And so we're gonna go into my SV Paramount profile. We go to Filters, Set Filters, and you can see here that the focus points are already entered. If you wanna know how I got those, you can go ahead and check out the card up here where I run through a focus routine. And we want to go to the flats. Now we have to do this for every single filter we're using. And what we want to do is set a flat box brightness. Now I've already done the hard work and I've figured out what the maximum brightness is and how long each flat will be at that brightness for all of my flat frames that I'm doing. Since I only image at 1x1 binning, I just leave the rest of them empty. And I want to do 10 flats for my flat events. So you do this for each flat. And setting that flat box brightness per filter before you do this on your profile is essential. If you don't do that, your flat box won't turn on when it's doing the calibration wizard. These flat box brightnesses are a bit of trial and error. I recommend doing it at night in a dark room where it's warm instead of outside where it's really cold like tonight. You might spend an hour or two out here dialing in the right brightnesses and you'll wind up with cold hands. Hand warmers. I wish they made ass warmers. Once the flat box brightness has been dialed in per filter, you go to Tools, Flats Calibration Wizard. In here, you're going to choose the equipment profile that you're going to apply the flat frames for. It creates a brand new sequence. And then you have to go through each filter and check the one that you do. Since I image with 1x1 binning, that's the only one I want to check. I've also done this enough times to know that bottom up is a lot easier than top down, simply because of the way things get knocked off the bottom of the screen if you start at the top and work your way down. So now that I've got 1x1 binning selected for each of my filters and a predetermined flat box brightness for each of my filters, I can go ahead and move on to the minimum and maximum times that I want my flat frames to expose for during the calibration, as well as set a target ADU. The target ADU is set at 30,000 by default, and it has a tolerance of plus or minus 500. Honestly, I feel that the 500 is a little bit of a tight tolerance. You could probably get away with 1,000 if you have an ASI 1600. Remember, ZWO recommends somewhere around 20,000 ADU. So once we change our tolerance from 500 to 1,000, we take our minimum exposure, and we're going to make that 5 seconds, and our maximum exposure, 60 seconds. You can set whatever minimum or maximum you want, but with a ZWO camera, going below 1 second and getting good flats may lead to weird looking flats. You may wind up with some vertical bands or some other weird artifacts when you make your masters. So anything over 1 second will get rid of any of that bias signal that leaks in when it averages out in the stacking. Likewise, with the maximum, you don't want your flats to expose for too long. Otherwise, you would wind up with too much dark noise and you have to make dark flats for them. ZWO recommends that their ASI cameras use a 20,000 ADU flat frame. I've gone ahead and I've plugged 20,000 ADU in as my target, plus or minus 1,000, and I'm running each one of my filters in one-by-one binning. I have the minimum exposure value set to 5 seconds, and the maximum exposure value set to 60 seconds. So the flat calibration wizard just wrapped up, and now that it's done, it's figured out the ideal amount of time to expose each one of my filters at the target brightness for the flat panel to achieve about 20,000 plus or minus 1,000 ADU. All I have to do now is click this save button and it will write these exposure times into my profile. And we can view that by going back into Tools, Equipment Profile Manager, select the correct profile, go to Filters, Set Filters, and click the flats, and you can see 18.17 seconds. If you want to go back in and tweak these a little bit and round them, be my guest. I don't think it's really going to hurt anything. So now, to show you how you can use these flats that you just created, let's build a brand new sequence. Tonight, we're going to do the Pleiades, which is M45. So to do the Pleiades, which is M45, the easiest way to do it is to go to Tools, Framing and Mosaic Wizard. You're going to type in M45 scale. Is correct pixels. So now all you do is just draw any rectangle on the screen. That'll be the correct size of your sensor. That's about the orientation that I'm looking for, just like that. And so that's going to be the frame of the Pleiades when I go to start the sequence. So from here, I literally click create sequence. What I want to do here, append targets to the sequence. How about we replace the targets in the sequence? Auto-rotate, we don't need to do that. Precision centering, we'll just slew and then center, and then I don't want to associate this image with my sequence because I don't want it to open every single time that I load the sequence. Click OK. We get this little warning, which is fine. Click Yes. OK. New sequence is up. I'm going to do filter red, green, blue, delete this, delete that. Exposures, 120 seconds. Repeat, we're going to do 30 of each. Each one of those. Then we go to Tools, Flats Wizard. We want to add a flat event after each light event. Do not add the pauses and click OK. Now, if you've got a user profile like I have here, then you can go and set the start times. So we want to slew in the target, we want to center on the target when it starts. Here's the RA and deck. And then if we want to start and end, we can go to planning tool. And we want to start when it's about 30 degrees up, which is right about now. We'll go about 5 minutes from now. So you click there. And then we're going to let it end once it hits. Say we let it run to 5 in the morning, which is more than enough time for this sequence to finish. And it should unpark the telescope and begin taking the lights, and then immediately start taking flats after it does its focus routines. So with that, we're gonna let this do its thing, and when it's done, you should see an image right about now.